green and always green. Try my fruit, the taste is really good. Don't be mean, protect my gene.
Learning about the forest!
It's a great pleasure to have you all here. Thank you for joining us. I would like to welcome you all on behalf of the HSPN. I'm personally very happy that we've managed to get you all together, because this is something that was in my mind of combining our power on the regional level, our expertise of our NGOs to do something, and we already discussed it with Stanimir and Razvan in India. And even since then, we wanted at HSPN to do something to bring our organizations together. So I think this is a very exciting first step, and this looks like it's going to be a great project. I want to thank our sponsor, Tetra Pak, for making this possible, because without their help, we couldn't have done it.
A special thanks to the teachers from all four countries. It's you who will be implementing what we decide and what we work on over the next few days. I know it's not an easy job, but I can think of no better topic at present than using forests to mitigate climate change.
Silver birch, again a northern tree species, is the same. It reaches its southernmost limit in northern Greece. There was, I'll tell you why I say was, there was only one place in the Rhodope Mountains where we had a forest. But birch is what they call a pioneer species. It's the first to arrive in a disturbed area, and then as the vegetation process goes on, it gets replaced by other more competitive trees, so pines and hornbeam. This was already happening, and is happening in northern Greece, and from what was once a forest, it was the biggest forest about 20 years ago. Now you have only stands, there's no forest.
The stability of the forest system is very much in jeopardy. So that is with respect to temperature during summertime. If you look for rainfall, and you can see here, there are different aspects. There are positive signs to the north, but negative signs to the south. And most, as you can see, the effects are more pronounced as you go to the south.
In fact, there are a lot of misconceptions, I would say myths, and a lot of wrong management practices, which undermine the restoration of the forest ecosystem after an incident of forest fire. Which usually leads to its degradation or even the complete change of the land use, of the forest land use.
The common focus areas that we see from consumers, customers, and everybody is these four pillars. Climate change, resource depletion, waste and water. Behind every pillar we have specific activities. Today on resource depletion and waste.
We are going now to have the presentations from the participating countries. Tomorrow we are going to visit the Environmental Education Center of Elefsina. It's another Environmental Education Center like the one that Themistocles presented us. We are going to do some field work in the city of Elefsina and afterwards in the mountain forests. During the last day, we are going to have some working groups. For educational materials, and there are going to be some interviews.
And now it's time for the educational activities templates to be presented. First, the Bulgarian team.
What are the reasons for biodiversity loss and how we can help? The second part of the lesson is a simulation game. We live in the area of Strange Mountain, where the biggest predators, the brown bear, has vanished. By this game called the Sad Bears and the Happy Bears, we would like to make our students realize what is the connection between the habitat, the impact of the climate change on the animals' shelter, food, and life conditions.
Live in Cyprus, the program runs in 85 schools. We have 5,500 pupils, which is a very big number for Cyprus. This is the little tree we use for the LEAF program that we give to the schools when they complete their first year with the first green leaf on it. And there are four more places if they continue for another 4 years. we picked the theme of climate change and forest fires because last year in Cyprus we had a huge fire that burned a big side of the mountain. So we are very sensitive to forest fires, and that's why we chose this theme. The little forest guardians in action, they have to be in the forest. They have to take initiatives, and of course, raising awareness, not only in the school, but also in the community, because we want our programs to be developed into society, into the community.
First of all, I want to welcome you to Greece, and I would like to present to you our theme, Trees as Carbon Storage. The cards are either knowledge or behavior cards, both referring to the forest ecosystem. And the pupil should develop positive attitudes towards the environment, understand man's interdependence with the natural environment, understand the need for sustainable development, and develop cooperation and communication skills.
We joined the LEAF group thinking of the importance that forest represents for children, for pupils, for their parents, for their teachers, for everybody.
We are going to have a walk in the forest, and the children will walk in two groups. The first group will walk through the forest and observe the dry branches and the leaves fallen down. And the second group will walk through a deforested area and observe the place and give reasons about the use of the cut trees.
Western Attica, in the Bay of the Elefsis, which is
part of the city square. And for the younger world, sometimes I say that if you were there, what would you do?
I am Antonis, I am from Cyprus, and I throw
you. I'm Sofia from Greece.
My name is Vidilina and I come from Bulgaria.
My name is Barry McGonigal, and I'm the International Director of the Learning About Forests program. LEAF, as it's known, is one of the five educational programs of the Foundation for Environmental Education. I'm here in Athens at the moment as a guest of the HSPM to begin work on the Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation project. Funded by Tetra Pak, this project involves four countries, Greece, Bulgaria, Cyprus, and Romania. Their four organizations are represented here today. The aim of the project is to engage children on the themes of forests and fire, forests and biodiversity, forests and climate change, and forests and energy. These four themes will be shared between the countries and be implemented amongst all the school systems in those countries. We've been very privileged to see the engagement from the teachers here today. They're extremely excited and motivated to get on with this project. We begin in January of next year in the pilot phase and hope to run for many years into the future. Key to the success of this project is that the students, when challenged, will find innovative solutions to overcome these challenges. Very important is that they disseminate these solutions to the community, both school and local wider community. The importance of this is that everybody can learn together to avoid making the mistakes of the past and protect the environment for the future. I have no doubts that this project is going to be extremely successful. It's going to run extremely well in the first year and many years to come. The regional collaboration we are seeing as part of the Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation project will produce resources which can be disseminated and used throughout the LEAF network. I have no doubt that we are seeing the beginning of an incredibly successful project, and I would like to thank all the participants and the sponsor Tetra Pak for their time and efforts. The climate is changing. We need to act, we need to inform, and we need to educate. This project ticks all those boxes, and that's why it's going to be so successful. Thank you.
The Hellenic Society for the Protection of Nature is involved with the educational programs of the Foundation for Environmental Education since 1992, and we're implementing LEAF since 2001. We strongly believe that one of the greatest strengths of the FEE is its extensive family of dedicated, experienced national operators and its even more extensive family of educationals and teachers involved in its programs. In this context, we have been thinking for a long time about a project that would involve neighboring national operators in a common goal. When the opportunity arose through our cooperation with Tetra Pak, an international company that has a strong commitment to environmental values, we jumped at it and we decided to design a project involving the national operators in neighboring Bulgaria, Romania and Cyprus. When thinking about a subject, we decided to address climate change, which is one of the biggest issues of our times. In this way, Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation was born. It will be implemented as a pilot project for 1 year, involving 2 schools in each country, and if all goes well, it may be extended to more schools and more countries in the years to come. HSPN has the overall coordination and management of the project. This was the first live meeting in which the teachers involved in each country and a representative of the national operator participated in order to design the educational material and set out all the details of the project. The design of the educational activities has been almost completed. The final details will be ironed out in the next few weeks, and implementation will start in the beginning of the new year, culminating in 1 day of common activities in all 4 countries sometime in March. I would like to thank our sponsor, Tetra Pak, for making this project possible, the organizing team and staff members of the HSPN for their hard work, and all the participants of the 4 countries for their great contributions.
I'm Dimitrios Gotzos. I'm the president of the Hellenic LEAF Coordinating Committee. In Greece, LEAF is jointly coordinated by the Hellenic Society for the Protection of Nature and Athens B Directorate of Primary Education of the Ministry of Education, Research and Religious Affairs, where I work as an Environmental Education Officer. The Coordinating Committee consists of members of the HSPN board as well as stakeholders from primary and secondary education. LEAF program supports teachers in primary and secondary schools throughout the country who implement environmental education projects. We organize teacher training seminars and summer schools on forest education. We also organize 3 seed planting activities, and we develop educational material with suggested activities. Also, every 2 years in special ceremonies, schools that implemented the program successfully are awarded with a fieldwork bag. Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation is a program founded by Tetra Pak Hellas that will run during the current year with the participation of Greece, Bulgaria, Romania and Cyprus. In this program, teacher groups from the participating countries will design and develop educational activities focused on forest contribution to climate change adaptation and mitigation. Our project could be seen as a response to SDGs 4, 13 and 15, who call for quality education, climate action and sustainable forest management, respectively.
As Tetra Pak, our approach to sustainability derives from our brand promise, protects what's good. That means protecting food through our processing and packaging activities, but it also means protecting people, and it means protecting future, our planets, our customers and our own. We have 3 key objectives to drive our environment excellence: to develop sustainable products, to increase recycling and to reduce our environmental footprint across the value chain. A very important factor that helps us achieve our environment goal is consumer awareness. Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation is one of the school programs that we are running to increase consumer awareness, and I'm very happy to be part of it.
I am Michael Ieridis and I am the national operator of LEAF in Cyprus. Cyprus is very interested in this Balkan cooperation, associating forest with climate change, especially as regards to forest fires. The last couple of years, Cyprus has suffered a lot from forest fires. It is for this reason that we were so interested in this Balkan cooperation to develop themes relating to the prevention, the protection of forests from fires, and also the measures to restore the burnt forests. We would like to thank the Hellenic Society for the Protection of Nature and the sponsor of the program, Tetra Pak, for hosting us in such a wonderful way here in Athens.
My name is Alexandru Sava. I'm from Romania and I represent the Carpathian Dunamian Center for Geoecology. I'm the national operator for the LEAF program. In Romania, it has implemented from 2002 and it has been a real success since then. And also, I wanted to tell you that the progress for the LEAF program has been increasing in every year, and last year we had almost 1,000 registered projects. Especially the children are very, very involved and happy to be in the forest, to be to experience nature in general. Over 1,000 teachers were involved directly, and another 200 indirectly. And let's say it was a really fun working with them and having a close communication, maintaining a close communication. I'm happy and honored to be part of this program and to meet a lot of interesting people. And I certainly hope that this topic related to climate change will be to have a really big impact towards children and to raise awareness. And since it started, the children started to make a lot of activities related to that. The children are very happy and looking forward to discover the new theme, forest and energy. They want to make as many activities as possible and to discover what are the types of energy that the forest can offer and how can they use them to make the environment a better place.
My name is Stanimir Georgiev and I'm chairman of the board of the Bulgarian Bullflag Movement. I also manage the Learning About Forest program in Bulgaria, and it is my honor to take part in this fruitful project together with countries from organizations from Greece, Cyprus and Romania. Climate change is an indisputable fact. It is not anymore an abstract phenomenon from science fiction, threatening only distant ice continents, lowlands or islands. Climate change is something we witness in our everyday lives, directly when we get struck by a disaster or indirectly when we need to adapt our needs and routine due to its effects. Climate change is no more a risk for tomorrow. Its impact reminds us constantly how vulnerable we are if we do not act right away. We should raise awareness and create cooperations. Local, national, international. Bulgaria is the second country in Europe for its rich forest biodiversity. Its green potential is really substantial, but we need to act strategically, systematically and on larger scale. Climate smart forestry and agriculture are key methods for mitigation of climate change in Bulgaria. Conservation of plant and animal species is a precondition for preservation of life on Earth. Urgent action by all, from governments to businesses and individuals, can limit the impact of climate change. For this, working with nature rather than against it must be a key strategy. We must enhance the resilience of natural systems rather than weaken them at the time when they are most needed. That is why our mutual pilot project, Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation, run in four Balkan countries, Greece, Cyprus, Romania and Bulgaria, is a wonderful and effective way to raise awareness about the negative impacts of climate change, to stress on the importance of acting now together to manage the unavoidable and avoid the unmanageable.
My name is Antonis Polidoru. I come from Limassol, Cyprus, and I'm a teacher at the 11th Limassol Primary School. I'm here because I'm participating to the LEAF project. Cyprus, as you probably know, it's a small island in the Eastern Mediterranean. And in that sense, it's very much affected by the climate change. And that's why we are very conscious about the need for preserving our forests who are endangered. And we decided that we need to focus our actions towards presenting the the natural heritage of our country. So we believe that prevention is always more effective than restoration. So we believe that is there is a need to start early and focus mainly on children. What actually we do in the context of LEAF, we bring closer the forest to the kids, to the students. Our students learn about forests, learn about especially the forest of their country, the species, the vegetation, in generally the flora and the fauna of our forest. They learn about the benefits that the forest can have to the society and the life of people in general. They learn about the dangers and the challenges that the forests, our forests are facing nowadays and in the near future. So through learning by doing practical activities, they get involved, they touch the trees, they plant trees, they observe the life of the forest, and through this process they finally become aware, they love the forest, and they become aware of the need to preserve and be guardians of the forest. I believe that this seminar, this three-day seminar in Athens, it's a great opportunity for us as teachers to get to know each other, to see what other countries are doing in the same field, to exchange ideas and good practices that we can use through our work.
Hello, my name is Kawiana Dimitrova and I'm from Bulgaria. First of all, I want to say about LEAF. It is represented in Bulgaria by the Bulgarian Blue Flag Movement. Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation was a really huge project and was a wonderful way to cooperate with the Balkan countries. I'm really glad to be a part of this project. Each school has to prepare, of course, activities that and test them to the pupils. All the class schools on our national activities were gathered, so we presented this to the project, and we really cooperate with this action. Forest Action for Climate Change Mitigation was a huge step to the future to make this a very responsible solution for making this world a better place. As the next step, schools will organize eco code competitions. The best one will be awarded, of course, and shared among the project network. The climax of the project activity would be the action days dedicated to the theme of the project, and of course the climate change mitigation and the impact with the biodiversity. Thank you for everything. Thank you for this opportunity.
This project has got three stages. One, an indoor one, an outdoor one, and an evaluation one. Everybody knows that. But from my point of view, I would focus more on the outdoor activities, trying to make our new generations to use their soul, okay, to really understand that there is a big danger to the forest, to all the climate changes in our world. If we want them to have shade tomorrow, we have to act today. And in our school, always these kind of activities involve families, friends, the local community. This way, spreading the word this way and trying to involve them all, okay, we thought that the impact would be more general, would have a final happy ending.
Hello, my name is Yannis Vasiloudis and I'm a primary school teacher from Greece. I'm very excited to be part of this project. I would like to thank EFI for this cooperation. I'm sure that the benefits for our pupils will be too many. Our theme was forest and CO2, trees as carbon storage and climate change. All activities have been based on experiential and collaborative learning. As international research has shown, the environmental knowledge is not the most significant factor about environmental awareness and environmental behavior. What have our pupils to know? They have to know about the forest contribution to the climate change mitigation. They will learn this by doing a lot of activities in their schoolyard, inside their classroom, or participating in outdoors activity in a forest. Finally, I would like to point out the need for the dissemination of these project results. I'm sure that in this way, more teachers will be involved in this project and this will benefit more students. Thank you.
It was a great pleasure to have our partners from Bulgaria, Cyprus and Romania here in Greece for the 3-day workshop on forest action for climate change mitigation, and have the opportunity to discuss this very important issue with them. As time goes by, we can observe the growing impact of climate change on our everyday life through the increasing appearance of phenomena which appear as natural disasters. Natural occurring changes in climate have been greatly accelerated by increased emissions of greenhouse gases, mainly CO2, resulting in global warming. Trees have the ability to absorb large amounts of carbon and sequester it. Thus, forests play a key role in climate change mitigation by balancing the concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere. For example, forests in the European Union absorb the equivalent of nearly 10% of total EU greenhouse gas emissions each year. Taking action to mitigate the effects of climate change by achieving a sustainable lifestyle is a common challenge for all people around the world. Sustainability cannot be obtained without cooperation and unity between corporations, government, local authorities, school communities, environmental NGOs, citizens and expert scientists. Through this project, our future citizens will have the opportunity to develop environmentally responsible behavior through direct involvement in the environment. They are learning about the importance of trees in combating climate change. They are learning in the forests, about the forests, and for the forest.
Learning about the forest!